That is Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah Al-Mu'minun. Surah Al-Mu'minun is a fairly short surah that characterizes the most important characteristics of the believers. And this is something when we read the Quran, when we read the surah, we have to all the time put in our mind that Allah is talking to us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, this means He's addressing us as believers. He's talking to us. And that is why we have to pay attention, special attention, to the ayat, to the whole Quran, of course, but the ayat, especially the ayat that addresses the believers, the mu'mineen, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu. And that's why it is so important for us as believers to ponder around the Quran, especially when we read these ayat that addresses us as believers. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, during his time when he received the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has all his companions around him. So they've seen the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They witness the revelation of the Quran coming to our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they've seen all the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they've seen all of that in their eyes. So those Sahaba radiallahu anhu, they've seen all of these things. We did not. We did not have that chance to see all of that. So we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we believe in the prophets, we believe in the Quran, we believe in all what our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us to believe in. And that is why, so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses al-mu'mineen, this means He's addressing us. Inshallah, we will talk about the characteristics of the believers in this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَى أَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون الذين يرثون الفردوس هم فيها خالدون اللهم اجعلنا من هؤلاء. الله سبحانه وتعالى سورة المؤمنين says قد أفلح المؤمنون. The believers, they have all the success. Success is the characteristics of the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah talks about the characteristics of the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is characterizing us that when we establish salah, we establish salah with khushu', with humility, because we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of heavens and earth, the creator of us. So we have to make khushu' in the salah. What does that really mean? The scholars, they say that when we say Allahu Akbar takbirat al-ihram, this means that we leave everything behind us and then we concentrate on being in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is al-khushu'. Khushu' means to have humility, to witness in our heart that we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we perfect our salah based on these characteristics. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. Those, the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that they would not have any filthy talk. Either they are saying something good or they will not say anything. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, he said, about the mu'min, فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ يَسْمَتْ, which means either you say something good or you don't say anything. But you don't involve yourself in bad talk. And bad talk can be a whole different subject or dars or khutbah that you can talk about. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he talked to one of the sahaba, he talked about, he said, أوصني, give me an advice. And he said, أمسك عليك لسانك. And he held his tongue. So our descent is spiritual level, which means that we can say bad things and we can say good things. The choice is ours. So when we talk about our brothers backbiting here and there, when we talk about filthy things, that has nothing to do with our well-being. That is also to be level. And this moment of level and talking has something to do with morals. Islam taught us, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba taught us how to have morals, how to deal with people, how to deal with ourselves, how to deal with our family, with our neighbors, with our friends, with the people around us, whether they're Muslims or non-Muslims. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. In the Arabic language here, when we say, and he's talking about those people who pay the zakat. And payment the zakat here in this surah, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. This means those are the people who are making zakat as a reality for them to pay it for the needy people. And zakat is a whole different subject that we can talk about for a long time. Zakat is the amount of money that we have to pay to the poor based on the wealth that we accumulate in this dunya. And in a very brief, basically talk about the zakat. If you have like wealth that you saved for 1 year, which is 12 months, then you have to pay, if it's like, for example, cash or money, then you have to pay 2.5% of that. That's for zakat. And then there is zakat shares for every wealth, every type of wealth that we do as believers. And another characteristic that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us, and he says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. Those are the people who will not have any indecent relationship with a woman except with their wives. And that's an ayah, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. This means those are the people who protect themselves from committing zina, and that's as the scholars say, illa ala azwajihim, except on those on their wives, or mamalek aymanum, those people whom they own, fa innahum ghayru malumin, and for those people they will not be blamed for it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, kaman ittagha wara'a dhalika fa ulaika humul adun. Anybody, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that who is going to be doing something against that, or going to go in the opposite directions of what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, then they are considered to be al-adun. Al-adun means those are people who make i'tidal, which means that they do things against what is being instructed in the Quran. And that is al-adun that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing as al-adun. And another feature of the believers, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. And those people who are keeping, if somebody is giving them something to deliver, say money or anything else, then those people are careful about delivering that amana, because they that amana. And the amana also can mean a lot of things in our lives. For example, our children, our family are amana in our for us as believers, which means it's important for us to raise our children the right way, to deal with our families the right way. These are called amanat that we have to really, we have to really do when we are dealing with our people. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. Here we talk about al-ahd. Al-ahd means that the promise that we make. Whenever we make a promise, then we fulfill that promise. Of course, you know, promising something is part of the characteristics of the Muslim, and also part of the characteristics of the believer. إن الله سبحانه وتعالى says والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون. This in this in these four lines of the surah, Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned the salah twice. The first one الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. Those are the people who are practicing خشوع or humility when they are standing in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about salah another time where he says وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Those are the believers who make sure that they do not miss the salah. And it means that they protect their salah. They make sure that their salah, they make their salah on time. They come for Jum'ah and they come early and they perform the salah. And also protecting the salah means also to pray the salah the right way, and that means that we make the right perfect our wudu and perfect our salah in terms of the motions as well as in terms of the khushu', and that's all part of protecting our salah. And when we pray, we all the time have all our attention that we're standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and talking to Him. And that's why we forget about everything else around us in this dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. Those are the people who are going to inherit the goodness in this dunya and in the hereafter. If we are characterized by all of these characteristics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he talked about the level, and the level means that talk about things that we say that are not in agreement or in alignment with the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He talked about different types of hadith addressing that subject. And then if we continue with the surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْرِقُونَ. Those people, the believers, all the time they have this fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that fear is in the heart. We all the time, whenever we try to do anything that is not in alignment with the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the instructions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we fear Allah. We all the time in our mind, we think that Allah is watching me. Allah is listening to me. Then that's why we have that fear and when we try to do something that is not right. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. And those are the people who believe in the ayat that was revealed to in the Quran by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. Those are the people that they will fast going to do good deeds. And also, those are the people who are going to be from the first people in the first lines to do the good deeds. أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. And during this ayah, the ayah in Surah Al-Mu'minun, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا أُوتُوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَى رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. السيدة عائشة, she asked the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم about this ayah. She said, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. And she asked Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, what does this ayah mean? Which says, those people who do things, but at the same time their heart is having, their heart are wajah, which means that they have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she said to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, are those the people who drink alcohol and also they steal? And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded to her, he said, La ya bint al-Sadiq. Those are another group, ya bint al-Sadiq, the daughter of al-Sadiq, which is Abu Bakr al-Sadiq, as you know that Aisha is the daughter of Abu Bakr. ولكنهم الذين يصومون ويصلون ويتصدقون وهم يخافون ألا يتقبل منهم. She said, he said, those are the people who fast Ramadan and who pray and they pay charity, and those are the people who are afraid that all their deeds will not be accepted by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So that's the meaning of qulubuhum wajila. It's like, you know, we pray, we do all things, and then we all the time have that fear that all these deeds will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah accept from all of us all the deeds, inshaAllah. And those people also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about here, they are mu'mineen, just the people who all the time come to the masjid. All those people who participate in building masajid, those people who all the time the Quran is their book. They do not read the Quran for a long time. They all the time read the Quran. They ponder over the ayat. They try to understand it. And those people who make istighfar at all times, during the day and during the night, and those are the people also who hold themselves accountable for things. You know, at the end of the day, when we put our head on our pillow, I mean, do we ask ourselves, what did we do today? What are the things, the right things that we've done? What are the things that are not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So we hold ourselves accountable when it comes to that. أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أسيج ولا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها ولدينا كتاب ينطق بالحق وهم لا يظلمون. In this ayah, it's a scary ayah. Allah سبحانه وتعالى he said that we will not hold people responsible for more than what they can handle. But Allah سبحانه وتعالى says ولدينا كتاب ينطق بالحق وهم لا يظلمون. Then we have a book that we put everything in it. And we will not transgress against anybody. So that's the ayah that can be scary for us when we read that ayah. It means there's a book. We have two angels on our shoulders that are recording everything. So that's something that we should keep us all the time alert to obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeing us. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين